Asked Darren Edwards to come and join us as well. Hello. Yeah, how are you?
Yeah,
you
know, all right.
Everyone's saying it's like the first day of...
Just for Charlie's knowledge, I got an A in English.
He got an A in English. But it's a real feeling, sort of first day back at school.
Certainly. You know, having had a 6-month summer holiday, so
the one you didn't want at all.
No, exactly. Unfortunately, we didn't race here last season, so I think the last day I came here, I was fortunate enough to have 3 winners, but obviously that was 2019, I guess.
Yeah, because it was rained off last year, wasn't it?
Yes, I think it was.
They never quite managed it. And you've come miles, because although you're a West Country person by birth, Leicestershire based?
Yeah, absolutely. So I've actually come...
Oh, you seem to have Fisher German on your cap and jacket. Is that a hint of what you do?
So I'm a surveyor. Yeah. So and actually we've just opened an office in Exeter.
All right.
So, but for the last 14 years I've been based in Market Harbour. So actually just down the road from where that winner's come from. So the winner of that last race, the Wetherby horse, is near sort of Waltham on the Wolds, Melton Mowbray direction. So that one's actually come further than me.
So new office in Exeter, does that mean you're going to be moving down here?
That's the plan. I'm just in the process of selling my property in Leicestershire at the moment. Head back down this way.
And what's the first day of the season? What are the thoughts in terms of the horses you've got to ride and what'll come up in the months ahead?
Yeah, so I had a second in the men's open race. A horse called Nava Man ran a really, really good race.
He's a grand horse, isn't he?
Yeah, he's to be honest, he's too good for me to ride, really. Normally, I don't get to ride ones as straightforward as him. But, he ran an absolute barnstorming race. I thought I went plenty fast enough, to be honest. But, you know, when Will came sort of cantering beside me after 2 out, it was quite frustrating. But we beat all the rest sort of out of sight.
And the winner's a bit younger than you and sort of still a bit progressive, isn't he?
Yeah, the winner's, I think, a 6-year-old Rising 7, whereas... the horse I was on was 11 Rising 12, but to be honest, as far as West Country point-to-point horses go, he's probably as good as any about, so it's just unfortunate he's bumped into one today.
And he's 11 years old, he's won 11 races, he must just be, is it just great fun, because he sort of almost knows more about it than you?
Exactly.
Well, that's a bit unfair, but you know what I mean.
he's very, very straightforward, but it, it's like with anything in life, if you enjoy something in life, you give 110%, and that horse enjoys racing, and he gave 110%, and to put it into context for anyone that's sort of watching, obviously the winner's rated 148, last run in the Cheltenham Festival,
ran well in a per temps or something like that.
Looking at the form before today, obviously we didn't know what was going to sort of turn up, and looking down the form, looking at that one, he would have actually been carried second top weight behind Frodon in the feature chase at Cheltenham today. So it puts it into context, and the winner of that ladies' race is rated 139, and they're still relatively young horses. Yeah. So for point-to-pointing, it's brilliant, because for anyone watching, for anyone that's never been point-to-pointing, the quality of horse and quality of animal that you get to see is fantastic. So, we're in a sort of wet field on a wet day in Devon, but you're seeing horses that are otherwise running around on ITV.
And those two horses you mentioned are going to be running, hopefully, all the way through the season in big races.
I've no doubt that they have aspirations to, and you can find out when you interview the winning jockey. But they ran the horse that the other horse in the same colours there, Topwood, ran here a couple of years ago and won in sort of similar fashion. So I imagine, well, I don't know, they'll probably take the same route with him. Yeah. And he was second at Cheltenham and won at Aintree. So just goes to show, you see good horses.
Absolutely. Final thought. So the season goes on now, all being well, fingers crossed, until June. Practically every Saturday now, circled off with point-to-point rides for you.
If you're not moving
to Exeter.
No, I'm not as busy as I once was. Probably realistically, I probably now won't ride until the Silverton meeting, which is just up the road from here,
3 weeks
in the middle
tomorrow,
of November.
Yeah,
so,
3 weeks tomorrow.
It's nice to get started. I'm a bigger fan of when it gets going after Christmas, because then it's more consistent you get into more of a sort of routine. So.
Yeah. Well, look, I was about to say keep dry, but you're going to have to go from the dry from here. But great to chat, and best of luck for the week's ahead.
Thanks very much.
And good luck with the move down to Exeter, hopefully.
Yeah,
let's see.